Hey, Kamusta? Mr. Barot here. This is another Simple Catholicism for Pinoy vlog. And this is our vlog number 6. And as you may see, wala ako sa aking usual background and I am here in front of our home altar. Dito mismo sa bahay namin. And just for your information, we really intended to place somewhere in our home, a home altar where we can really pray. In front of it, we can offer our prayers, especially in front of our images. Na, of course, known ng Catholics about images and a little bit of statues. Mamaya, itur ko kayo with whatever we have in our altar. And as you may also notice, the colors, it's already Advent. And just the past weekend, we've celebrated our first Sunday of Advent. So, does anyone of you know what Advent is? Hopefully, yes. And those who did not, let me tell you something about it. Just a little bit. Hindi ko ikakomplicate. Kaya nga simple Catholicism. Pero at least you are aware of what Advent is all about. Advent is important for Christians. Okay? Advent means preparation. Okay? Preparation for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Sa Pasko. Kaya past Sunday, upon the posting of this video, this is our first Sunday which is composing of 4 weeks bago pumasko. So we are preparing. This is Advent is preparing for the coming with hope. Okay, looking forward. This is somehow the opposite of Lent, which we use the same color, purple and that pink. So we use the same color for Lent, but the Lent is for repentance. Okay, the way I looked at it, okay, not necessarily officially by the church, but Advent is preparing for our Lord Jesus Christ coming to earth. The Lent is preparing through repentance. Advent is through hope in preparation for Christ leaving this world of ours. So that's how I looked at it para mas maganda yung perspective ko on how we celebrate Advent and Lent using the same colors. Hindi kami ganito dati. Nagkaroon kami ng opportunity to do it and practice what our church does. So that's why recently, pinatanto ni Mrs. Barurot na color purple kasi yun talaga ang kulay ng Advent, technically kulay ng Christmas. Now, siyempre sabihin niyo bakit hindi pula and green? Pula and green is the typical related to Santa Claus, Christmas tree. Pero when you look at Christianity itself, it's all about purple, which is parang somber, okay? Kasi nagtitika, nagre-reflect ka, kaya purple yan. And you will notice that in the masses in this next 4 weeks bago mag-Christmas, each candle will be lit up as, just for your information, okay? 3 purple and 1 rose, which is yung rose basically nasa pangatlo. So 3 purple means prayer, okay? Penance and preparation. And then yung pink, which is somewhere in the middle, on the third one, it's about rejoicing, it's joy. Kasi while you're praying, while you're doing your penance, while you're preparing, there is this joy in your heart na alam mong may paparating na good news, which is our Lord Jesus Christ sa Pasko. So, kasama nitong pagpapaliwanag ng Advent, so of course, pwede kang magkaroon ng red and green, pero again, when you talk about Advent, it's all about purple and pink, especially for Catholics. So, yun dapat ang kulay ng Pasko. Okay, and again, the red and green are the secular colors. We also have red and green, but then in our altar, it has to be right. And it is aligned with, when you look at the masses, it's all in purple up until Christmas. Alright, so let me give you a tour of our home altar a little bit, okay? Ayan, so let me give you a tour of our simple altar, which again, sabi ko nga na we really specifically a lot of place for a home altar, kahit simple lang, pero we were blessed enough na meron kami nakitang corner. Hindi siya perfect, pero a corner where we can put our Lord somehow, our remembrance of our Lord na being part of our home. Kaya sana lahat kayo merong altar, especially mga kapatid namin mga Katoliko, lahat kayo may altar. Hindi kailangang bongga, hindi kailangang malaki, pero at least a special place para mailagay nyo ang ating Panginoon sa loob ng bahay nyo mismo. So, ito ang aming altar. Okay. Nandito siya pagpasok mismo ng pinto. So, pagpasok ng pinto, you will see that already, yan, sinisindihan namin ng kandila. Okay, sindihan natin. Ayan, nasindihan ko na yung kandila namin. Ito yung malimit namin sinisindihan pag nagdadasal kami dito, pag nagro-rosary kami dito sa baba. And kasama na doon pag nag-online or virtual mass kami. So, we set up the laptop here. Okay, we set up the laptop here. Tapos, kasi ang mass namin is Latin mass. So, the priest is facing ad orientem. Nakaharap sa altar, hindi nakaharap sa tao. So, as if our priest is facing also our crucifix here in our altar whenever he consecrates the bread and wine. Kaya, this is a perfect place for us to set up. Dito kami nakaupo sa harap mismo. Nakaupo kami dito, we were able to kneel and all that. So, that is how we practice and that's the one of the purpose of our altar. Alright, so we have a candle and we light that up pag nagsisimula na yung prayer or even pag nagro-rosary kami, nakabukas ang kandila. Parang nagmamas, di ba? Sa mas, hindi pwedeng walang kandila kasi it's a sign of you are in the presence of our Lord. Remember, Jesus Christ is the light of the world. So somehow, gusto namin maliwanag, na naliliwanagan kung saan papunta yung mga dasal namin, ginaguide ng mga ilaw. Kaya whenever we have candles in the altar, yun ang pinaka-purpose niya. So, pag nagdadasal ka, nakabukas na yung kandila. Okay? And sometimes, during very special occasions, okay, very special occasions, we uses the candle mass. Ito yung blessed candle. Yan, blessed candle galing sa priest when we attended the candle mass celebration sa simbahan. So, lahat ito blessed. And then, we keep it here for special occasions. Okay, so, and then recently, nag-birthday si Mrs. Barurot, and I think we've been wanting also to put up flowers in our altar. So, ginamit namin na rin yung binigay na flower sa kanya during her birthday. Ayan, so, that flower, now we put that in the altar in front of our, of course, our matriarch, our Blessed Virgin Mother, Mama Mary. Okay, and this painting or this picture is very particular kasi if you will see, alright, if you will see, that is the Eucharist picture that Jesus is handling and Mama Mary is there to support that part. Okay, so that is their relationship basically. So, and that is very Catholic. Okay, that's why we put that here in front of our, that's why we include that in front of our altar. Okay, sa Mama Mary. And then, gaya ng sinasabi ng iba, we don't honor the Bible so much. Well, yes, we do. Okay, we have our Bible in the middle and it's always, for us, we believe in Jeremiah 29:11, so it's always, it's even highlighted here. Okay, that one. It's highlighted there para yun ang aming laging nililook up to, that there's something for us na ginawa ni Lord. So, whatever is happening in our lives, it's always part of that plan. Okay, so we have the Bible and our rosary in the middle. We have our own personal rosaries also we used. And then, we have Our Lady of Guadalupe, very important. Okay, bakit kamo? Kasi when Our Lady of Guadalupe showed up in Mexico, that is in the 15th century, that's the year, or that's the century where Philippines is discovered. And she showed up in Mexico kasi nagkakagulo sa Europe about yung mga Protestant noon. Na nag-boom ang Protestantism sa Europe, so para makagather more yung mga nawalang faith ng mga Protestant sa Catholic faith before, binawi niya sa Latin America. Kaya siya nag-show up sa, hindi, not specifically her reason, pero it's a situation na we look up to na para mabawi niya yung mga nawala, nagpakita siya sa Mexico. Okay, kaya very important din kasi related yan sa pagkakadiscover sa Pilipinas and yung pagbawi ng faith ng mga dating Catholic na naging Protestant. So, nakagather siya ng milyong-milyong believers when she showed up sa Mexico. Another thing is we have our small Bibles here. Isa dito is Roman Missal na ginagamit namin sa aming Latin Mass. Okay, yan, Roman Missal. Hindi ito yung normal na ginagamit sa Mass. Okay, this is for the Latin Mass very specifically. So I may have to make another video about it. And then this is our personal Bible where we can bring whenever we have Bible study with our Catholic brethren here. Then we have also our small statues, very important also for us. First thing is si Saint Stephen, proto-martyr. Okay, makikita nyo siya sa Acts. Okay, makikita nyo siya sa Acts, siya yung in-stoned or pinukul ng bato hanggang sa mamatay while defending the faith that he got from the apostles about our Lord Jesus Christ. So very important. Okay, proto-martyr, the first martyr, Saint Stephen. This is given by our friend priest in Chicago, na yun ang parish niya, Saint Stephen proto-martyr. Kaya we have it in him in our altar. Very important, protecting the faith. And of course, another one. See, ang may pakpak, Saint Michael the Archangel. Okay, hindi ito yung beer, Saint Michael the Archangel mismo. And as always, the protection from the head. From the head of the angel, Saint Michael, especially on war, okay? General, kasi si Gabriel ang pinaka. Susunod natin i-discuss kung ano yung mga angels na yan. Pero at the moment, we have Saint Michael in our altar for additional protection, okay? And of course, the Divine Mercy picture, very important, very Catholic also. Okay, Divine Mercy coming from Sister Faustina's vision. And of course, the blood and water, red and white or blue. Okay, coming from the heart of Jesus. So that's the Divine Mercy. And again, this is biblical, blood and water. Okay? And syempre, ang aming crucifix with the Corpus Christi in the middle of it. And that's the difference between other denomination. Kasi other denomination only have crosses and don't have the Corpus Christi. Why? Because they believe that Jesus already resurrected. And for us, we immortalize or we basically make sure now we remember His suffering. Para ma-remind ka tayo or kami as Catholics na He really died for our sins. So He doesn't have to be out of the picture. The cross reminds us also, but again, seeing the Corpus Christi, the battered, the tortured body of our Lord, it reminds us of this so much hurt and pain that He took for us para ma save niya tayo from our sins. So we have the same faith and belief on that matter, pero I think Catholics are more detailed. Hindi mo masabing gore kasi we want to see Him battered and tortured in the cross, pero we feel it more and it reminds us more, it makes our faith deeper whenever we see that. Unfortunately, the wall has a thermostat in the middle. Hindi namin matanggal kasi ito yung may-ari ng bahay. So, hindi namin matanggal yan. So, wala kami magawa. And pinagsabi na namin, Lord, pag medyo malamig, i-adjust natin. Pag medyo nilamig ka sa thermostat. Pero, yes, that is our altar and, of course, our candle. So, during the ordinary days, these are just all white. And this is the first time we did our candles na in line with the season of Advent. And it will come back during the season of Lent. So, we have that. Hindi namin masindihan kasi andun lang yung smoke detector, baka ma-detect, mag-alarm, tumawag ng bumbero. Pero at least we've showed it like that. And again, that is prepared by Mrs. Barurot as usual. Even our linen is purple. So we are basically trying to follow and to see na may something special about our faith whenever we change colors in our altar. So it would be nice kung meron kayong altar na nagagawa niyo yan. So you have something to look forward to and meron kang inaayos sa altar, hindi lang alam yun, hindi lang siya may corner dyan. And then the rest, these are just for storage of candles, posporo, mga ganon, pamalit na kandila. So yun. So hopefully ma-share ko sa inyo on whatever we have in our altar and how we celebrate, how we change these colors based sa season ng church. So the church is starting its calendar through Advent. So yun ang ginagawa namin. Another one, we have another small altar upstairs. And hindi ko na muna ma-share kasi a little bit personal kasi nasa room yun, nasa kwarto namin. Pero almost the same. except that we don't have so much candles there or what, pero meron kaming crucifix, meron kaming picture ni Jesus tsaka ni Mama Mary as usual, and then there's also almost the same Bible and all that. So two altars, that is whenever we are making our rosary in the room. And then dito yung mga main, like yung virtual mass, tapos pag meron kaming prayer group meeting dito with our yung mga kaibigan namin, mga Catholic. Typical sa Pinoy na September, October, November, nagpre-prepare na sila for Christmas, decorations and all that. Even si Ms. Barro trying to convince me about setting up early, pero we also agreed na let's follow this one, kasi talagang ang preparation talaga starts immediately after Christ the King, which is very close sa birthday ni Miss Barurot. So we will not forget that. So Christ the King, and then immediately after it's Advent. So that's the only time we have set up our home to feel Christmas, kasi it's the official preparation for the coming of our Lord. So yan, sinet up si Miss Barurot, yan ang gustong-gusto niya, nag-set mo Christmas tree. We even set up our small Belen. Okay, small Belen here. And then that's it. And we change our some of our colors at home. So yun yung sinasabi ko na red and green. Kasi other parts of the home will be red and green, pero the altar is purely Advent colors. Okay, yun ang aming somehow to try to keep, to practice, to keep the tradition para ma-maintain siya, kasi yun naman talaga yung tinuturo sa atin ng church somehow. Pero it's not strict, okay? It's not very strictly practiced, pero if we can, we will. So I hope nakatulong ako, and the information that I gave you, at least as a simple Catholic who basically practices what the church does, I hope nakatulong ito to add more information sa inyo while you're practicing our faith, our Catholic faith. And para ma-practice at maituro nyo din, gaya like ko sinasabi, sana ma-share nyo ito sa ibang generation within your family. Kung hindi man sa labas, at least within your family, ma-share nyo. Which is our goal also in our families. Unti-unti, piece by piece, part by part, para hindi naman mabulunan. Kasi there's so much things to learn from our faith. Kaya sana unti-unti makakontribute ako, and somehow makatulong ito to develop more, and para tumibay mismo ang faith nyo as a Catholic, especially a Pinoy Catholic. So, until my next video, see you!